100-year-old prophecy, Jewish prophecy, Jewish mystic, that talked about what was happening with the solar eclipse that would take place in the future, which would be followed by a great defeat of the Eastern kings. Now, this solar eclipse would take place at the beginning of the month of Elul. And that happens to be on the 22nd of August of 2017. I'm going to go ahead and read it to you real quick here. And by the way, we are going to be live streaming the eclipse tomorrow. So if you want to check it out and see the full total, what they call the total eclipse, come over and check it out at our channel. If you're anywhere in America, you will see the effects of the eclipse, but you will not see the total eclipse, the complete eclipse, as only a small pathway that leads through the center of the country will see. But we will show you live stream footage of different feeds that are being fed into the social media, as well as some of the more professional outlets that are filming it, and we will feed it in and let you see what it looks like. It's supposed to be an amazing thing. But here's the prophecy. An esoteric prophecy written over a century ago described the solar eclipse that will traverse the entire United States next week, and predicted in shocking detail what the astronomical event portends for the outcome of the current North Korean and U.S. conflict. It goes on to say that total solar eclipse's timing is meaningful according to Jewish calendar, according to the Jewish calendar. Incredibly, it comes precisely at the beginning of a month in the Hebrew calendar called the month of Elul, singled out in a Jewish source as having significance for the specific political situation the U.S. is facing today with Eastern aggressors. Now, those Eastern aggressors would be North Korea and possibly, and I would say probably in the shadows there, China. The prophecy states that when a solar eclipse occurs exactly as it will next week, in the beginning of the month of Elul, kings of the East will suffer great loss, unquote. Rabbi Yosef Berger of the Rabbi of King David's tomb on Mount Zion, revealed of the century-old text, Yakut Moshe, which is called the Collection of Moses. And this is the Collection of Moses here, the picture of the cover, and it was written in 1894. It says, just a few hours after the path of darkness departs the coast of South Carolina and the sun sets, the Hebrew month of Elul begins, ushering in a 40-day period of repentance corresponding to the period Moses spent on Mount Sinai, repenting for the Jewish people. And that would have been when they went into idolatries. It says, written by Rabbi Moshe ben Yisrael Benjamin in Safed in 1894, the Yalkut Moshe notes that when a solar eclipse occurs at the beginning of the month of Elul, quote, it is an especially bad sign, Rabbi Berger told Breaking Israeli News. Now, another thing is that they've always said, the Jewish mystics, and in the Kabbalah, I believe it states that the solar eclipses are a bad omen or a sign against the nations. And when you see lunar eclipses, it's a bad omen for the Jewish people. So that's the way they've always looked at these types of events. But this is a particularly interesting solar eclipse in that it goes across the full of the whole of the United States, almost cutting the nation in half. And what I had read also, which I thought was fascinating, is last time that something like this happened in the United States was a preceding independence. which took place here in America, 1776, which I thought was really interesting.